That violence near Cleveland has triggered a review of safety procedures at districts throughout Ohio, including right here at Lakota East. That's where News 5's John London reports tonight.
Well, schools like this one that we're in now, Lakota East, have planned for a variety of scenarios. Gunmen in the band room, gunmen over by the lockers. 2,000 students here, every one of them have been through the drills.
It's such a change in mindset to what we used to do is lock doors, turn off lights, and just hope.
That was the pre-Columbine, pre-Virginia Tech method. Dealing with a gun in school emergency has evolved. Today's teenage students are taught to be active thinkers. It's drilled into them several times a year.
Are you going to run back to your classroom that's 250 feet away, or are you going to run out that door?
Locking classroom doors, setting up barricades, evacuating to predetermined places outside the school building. All are options depending on what can be learned about the situation.
If you are by that classroom, we've been given guidelines of what to do if the shooter comes into our classroom, ways to get out if they are by our classroom.
For multiple level schools like this one, students are instructed how to leave through upper floor windows. If a shooter's isolated in one part of the building, they want other parts vacated as quickly and as safely as possible.
It's important because our students change classes 7 times a day. The teachers have different kids in every class period.
Districts like Lawrenceburg and others have conducted drills with local law enforcement at times.
Sometimes you have new teachers who have no idea where the band room is.
Right. Yeah,
so it gets teachers thinking. We give them maps of the building.
Rich Bryant teaches this stuff. He'll tell you empowering students to think instead of knee-jerk is critical. For example, in a lockdown situation, if a fire alarm goes off, do you assume fire danger or consider that it could be a setup?
It's counterintuitive to think that sitting in a classroom and hoping for the best is the best way to survive this.
We are told it would be the rare school district, whether urban or rural, that would not have some type of Chardon-like emergency plan in place. At Lakota East, John London, News 5.